Is MB2 real or just totally made up? As a general dentist, I think it is totally made up, but I have my friend, nacho-tastic endodontist, Dr. Brett Gilbert, who's gonna be speaking at Super Dentist Boost coming up in just 2 weeks. And to get the most discounted tickets, I made up my own hashtag for my dental people. I don't know if Brett agrees. It's gonna be dentist cheap. To get the most dentist cheap tickets, 18 C credits for $18, just text Boost to 215-543-6454. Thanks for joining me, Brett. And our dad solidarity with the same sweatshirt, that's great. So tell us a little bit about yourself and what you're going to be sharing at Super Dentist Boost with our audience.
Oh man, thanks, Paul. Always love being with the Nachos, being with my buddy, Paul Goodman. Nice. Love what you guys are doing, your message, what you're building. And so, yeah, I'm fired up to be part of Super Dentist Boost. I'm going to be talking about some really cool things. First of all, I'm an endodontist from Chicago. Awesome. And just super passionate about what I do. I love to teach it. And so this is a great combination. I love to be with friends too. I know there'll be a lot of friends there at the Super Boost. So I'm going to go into some of the basics. So I want to go into four key topics that will really help the GP sort of navigate through trouble spots in the endodontic procedure. So we're going to talk first about access. You know, because I have this beautiful community of Access Endo with, you know, hundreds of doctors from around the world, I'm getting vibes of what dentists are really struggling with and wanting to learn more about. So I'm going to start off with some tips on access and then a little bit of discussion about this whole evolution that we're seeing in endodontic access preparation. I'm going to go into and talk about some really key tips on instrumentation, how to stay out of trouble. I think that that's really the key, is when you know where the potholes are, then you can drive around them as opposed to, you know, stumbling into them.
Or you can refer it to your friendly endodontist truck driver and say, this one's for you.
There you go.
You know, one of the things I like to share, Brett, as a multi-practice owner's GP, I have an implant focus, but I'm seeing regular patients. I'm being able to identify when something's going to be easy, medium, hard is so valuable. Even if you don't pick up a file, just to give your patients a heads up on the process, what they're going to be dealing with. So that's why what you're doing is awesome with Access Endo. We're really trying to just share awareness about, Brett, the fundamentals. I have this basketball at all time because I don't think Brandon's on, but Ben Simmons, a superstar basketball player, needs some fundamental help with just shooting. So you can be a super dentist and still go back to fundamentals. Would you agree with that?
Love the Philly plugs, always a Philly plug. Yes, exactly. And so access instrumentation, and then I want to talk a little bit about irrigation and some of the misconceptions about what you may or may not be accomplishing with your irrigation needle. And then finally, some tips on obturation to make it smoother and round it out with some question and answer, and really want to be available to the Nachos for any questions. And I'm just fired up to be a part of this community, and I just love it.
Well, our goal, Brett, I try to make things as simple as possible, is to take dentisting humans from feeling like this, which is easy, can't find MB2, and help you feel more like this by training your mind, your words, your hands, and your heart at the center of it. To see the amazing Brett speak, just text Boost to 215-543-6454. Our special ends tomorrow night. So if you want $18, 18 C credits for $18, you can text this in. Brett, now we're also be sharing, just tell us a little bit, give us a preview about the Access Endo community. We're going to be sharing more about this with Dental Nachos when your next course opens up, but tell us a little bit about Access Endo.
Oh yeah. So it's, you know, a dream vision of mine to create an online education platform for endodontics. And, you know, we have over 400 members from literally all corners of the world. We're all communicating. I'll be doing a live coaching call today, doing demos on the coaching call, going over cases. Our portal is really advanced. We have obviously all the video modules in the portal, lots of ways for the doctors to communicate with me, ask me questions. But one of the coolest upgrades that we did is we have a case upload portal, Paul. So a doctor that's part of it can upload a case, x-rays, comb beam, details, and then I can literally consult on the case with them and guide them through. And so that's been really a valuable thing. And along with the coaching, it really gives you that mentor. So it's certainly about education. I want to show you how to do it. I want to give you the tips. I want you to avoid the trouble, but you really need a mentor along the way. And that's really what the program's about. It's a mentorship.
I give you guys credit for that because it's so important for people. I think you can use this tagline. I use it for my associates. I want them to think they have a friend in their phone. So even if I'm not at the office, they can text me. Does Dottie want a crown for number 12? I'm like, don't mention crown to Dottie. I've known her for 10 years. Just right now, stabilize her tooth, give her a heads up that a crown would benefit. But my instinct, give her the menu. But that is so valuable because when you're in a jam, and someone just reached out to me yesterday, was so kind to them. They need an associate, Brett. And what we do is Dennis Job Connect. And he said, can I, you know, advertise for my associate? He goes, I just want to let you know your site really helped me. I stripped an implant screw and the nachos came to the rescue in just a few minutes. And what I think I was so proud of with that is that wasn't me at all. That was just my community. And you're building a community. And the more we do that to make dentists feel like they're not alone is so important.
Absolutely. I mean, as a founder of anything, you feel ownership toward it, but over time, as it evolves, you see it become its own thing. And that's really the goal. And the collective community, the effort, the way that people are proud to be a part of your community, that's really the magic. And so it's been an amazing ride and appreciate all your help along the way. You've been an advisor to me from day one.
Oh, my
and
pleasure.
So, super grateful for you.
Before we jump off, you know, because we're the same age, same medium age dentist, I was doing an interview. I'm going to be doing a marketing piece for our office that focuses on implants. And this woman who interviewed all these dentists, who was great, you know, she said, what do you want to say that differentiates you? And I said, I'm really not into differentiator competition, but what distinguishes our vibe is we try to make dentistry in our office like we're hanging out with friends, make it as fun as possible and a little bit funny. And she said, I never heard something like that before from any dentist. And that dentistry could be more fun. Dentists can have more fun. It's legal. I mean, our jobs are tough. The management part's tough. So to feel like you're part of something, I mean, everybody proudly wears, you know, I know this will be poignant to some people, maybe you're Midwestern, their Kansas City Chiefs jerseys or their Tampa Bay jerseys. Why can't we have that same feeling about what we do all day long? So Brett, thanks so much for being you. We are going to put accessendo.org in the comments, and to see Brett in just 2 weeks on a Saturday morning up helping you, just text Boost to 215-543-6454. Brett, if somebody wants to follow you on Instagram or any of your places, where's the best way for them to check you out?
I'm Dr. Brett Gilbert everywhere, including Clubhouse. For those that are into Clubhouse already, it's starting to really grow from a dental standpoint. And just before you leave, you know, you just said some really key things about, you know, you said body, mind, you know, spirit and of the dentist and a lot of the mental health issues we're having. Sure. And one thing that I like to tell people is there are some safe spaces. I've been named to the board of directors of Dental Mental Network, which is just a safe, supportive space. Our good friend Frank King is a part of that, Paul. I think you're a part of it. If not, we need you in there. We need We need your kindness. But the other thing that you just mentioned about having your office be fun and like you're hanging out, you know, it's important, you know, so you're a dentist with a side hustle. I'm a dentist with a side hustle. Yeah. I think we need to open our minds as dentists as to what we can bring to the table in different arenas. And when you do that, it adds a certain spice and excitement back that maybe you're missing with the doldrums of going in and being chained to the chair. So I think that it's important for all dentists and for us as leaders to open up the possibilities of what we can do as dentists and how we can, you know, create more income, create more happiness, and often leave a legacy and an impact on the world outside of our dental offices.
Love that.
And that's really exciting.
I appreciate it, Sharon. It goes with my theme of 2021. Your life as a business owner is always about money, but it also should always be about your morale. And the morale of dentists has not been talked about enough. And it's time for us to share in a kind way. So thanks so much, Brett. We'll see you at Super Dentist Boost. Really appreciate it.